What's going on, everyone? Today we're going to do a review on the Dirty Hand Tools 22 inch walk behind wheeled string trimmer mower. So over the past week, I've been putting this thing to the test. And I gotta be honest with you, online, I seen a couple of reviews and they just didn't make sense to me. Those are written reviews. I didn't find any video reviews. I went to post one on here for everyone to see because this is a good trimmer mower. It's a really good trimmer mower. Just like every other Dirty Hand Tools I've ever owned. Listen, this thing started right up. First pull right out of the crate. Couldn't believe it. Just like the generator. And if you haven't seen that video, check out that video as well. Excellent products. So what I want to do is actually take you around this trimmer. I'm going to show you some of the functionality and some of the features on this thing. And I'm going to show you how to adjust the line. I'm going to try to address some of the issues that I've seen other people having online about this mower. And there's a couple easy fixes if you just read the manual. So we're going to get to all that. And after we do that, I'm going to take you over here. And as you can see, I got a lot of high weeds that need to be cut down. And guess what? It rained for like the last 2 days. So not only are they high, not only are they thick, they're wet, they're nasty. So I'm gonna take this through it. And we're gonna show you how well this thing actually works. So first, let's take a look at the machine itself. It literally only took me 5 minutes to put this thing together. It comes in a box, you assemble the wheels, you tighten up the handle, and that's all there is to it. 5 minutes. You can see here, these wheels are 14 inches high, 14 inches wide, so they're very large. You only get two of them, one on this side, one on the other side. There's no wheel on the front, obviously. This is a trimmer mower, so that ball kind of glides on the ground and so on. Here's your air filter, your gas cap. Over here, you can adjust the handle simply by turning these knobs. There's one on this side, one on the other side, and you can make this go up, down, and it's more comfortable for you. Once again, your gasoline. Over here is your oil. So they will actually give you a tag that says put oil in this before you operate it. Once you do that, once you see that tag, just fold it up. It actually turns into the funnel. It's really cool, actually. You just put it in there, dump your oil in there, takes about a quart, and you're good to go. Here's your exhaust over here. Stay away from this side, it gets hot. Over here is your lever. You got the little bunny rabbit and you got the little turtle. Bunny rabbit's fast, turtle slow. So if you put this on slow all the way up here, it's going to shut your mower off. If you put it down fast, which you want, this is what you're going to cut the heavy brush with. So make sure this is all the way down. Once again, shut it off, come all the way up. Okay, simple as that. Let me get a closer look. There you go. The handle feature, which I'll show you in a bit, it actually works very well. You pull this back to engage the trimmer line. And what's nice about this machine is once you let that go, the trimmer line stops and it still runs. So if you have to go pick something up out of the yard, get something out of your way, you don't have to restart this every single time. So once again, you pull that lever back, it engages the trimmer line, you let go of it, the motor still runs, but it stops the trimmer line so you don't get your hands chopped off. In the package, you are going to get trimmer line. Now this is 155 right here. This is 155 mil. Now I'm going to try to address one of the problems that I've seen other people having in this video, and this is one of them. So a lot of people said that when they go through the heavy brush, the trimmer line breaks and it's junk. Here's the deal. There's different mils of trimmer line. This takes up to 175. So if you're going through heavy brush like this over here, even though we're going to use the 155 and it'll do it fine, there's 175 out there that you can buy. It's blue. You put it in the machine and it'll take those down like nothing. Okay, so trimmer line comes with this. You get about 5-6 pieces of it. These are about 23 to 25 inches long each, and I will show you how those go in. You want to make sure that when you cut these, they are the same length. If not, it's going to wobble the machine. Okay, so make sure 23 to 25 inches long. This is 155 mil. You can get something smaller, you can get something larger. You can get 165 and 175. All right, so here's something else cause an issue for you. When you're cutting, you do not want to blow what you're cutting back into your path, right? Your cut path. So there's a discharge. Think about a lawnmower. When you use a discharge chute on the side of a lawnmower, it's blowing all that heavy grass on the side. If you blew it in front of you, it's just gonna bog your mower down and it's gonna stall it out. So on here, what you need to remember is that when you're actually cutting, you're going in this way. Okay, this is your discharge. So when you cut, make sure that discharge blows that debris out that way, so you're not clogging this thing up again. So once again, bring it in this way, cut all of your weeds or your high grass here, let it discharge. If you just go in to a giant pile of weed, you're going to end up clogging that up, right? So you're gonna end up bogging it down. And I think that's one of the problems a lot of people are having. They're just going into this full bore. Think about a lawnmower. You know, it doesn't matter what size lawnmower you have. If your grass is too high and too thick, you're gonna go into that too fast and it's just gonna bog it down and shut it off. This is the same concept. So make sure that your debris is being shot out the debris field. All right, let's show you how to actually adjust this trimmer line, actually how to put it in. So I think this is another issue, the third issue I think people are having with this when they're going into their weeds. You know, once again, you don't wanna go in full bore, but I think people are actually putting this too close to the ground when they actually go in, because this is a powerful motor. So I'm going to show you how to adjust this here. I'm going to show you how to cut this, and I'll let you have a closer look at the motor here in a bit. Okay, so if you look here, you will see spacers. So you got one spacer, two, three, and four, and then you actually have the line itself. The bottom piece here screws off, so you're going to screw this piece off right here. All right, now you don't want to lose this because it's the bolt and the lock washer, the lock nut. So, lock washer, yeah. So now you got spacers. You wanna take these spacers out. Now they might be a little bit stiff if you haven't done it before. So you might wanna use some type of small chisel that I'm using. You can see there's two holes, one here, one here. This is flat. The flat goes down, okay? So you wanna make sure that flat piece goes down. So now you got another one here. So I'm gonna have to use my chisel because this is a little wet. Like I said, it rained and my hands are a little slippery. So I'm just gonna take it out like this. Okay. All right, so there is your next one. So this should slide off pretty simple. Now this right here is your actual trimmer line. Let me zoom out here a little bit. And you can see how you put these in. You're gonna put that line in like so. So you take it up, you wrap it around, and you bring it on down through, and it comes out like this. Make sure these are even, make sure these are even, and make sure they are cut to the same length. But you're gonna have two of these. Once again, these lines, you put it up through, wrap it around, back down in, and that is how you put those on. You can see here, there's two pins. Make sure these face down when you're cutting. And then if you get your spacer, let me grab one here. If you get your spacer, the reason why you want the smooth side down is because of these holes right here. When you're putting it back together, it goes like that, okay? So make sure that this flat part is down. These are down. All right, so let me take a couple more of these off. Well, actually, no, I don't want to take a couple more off. I actually want to go closer to the ground. So let's do that. So I'm going to add spacers now to the top. And these are cut out to match the actual shaft itself. And we're going to go, I think that's okay. We're going to bring this all the way down here. That's going to go down like this. Some reason I can't line it up. There you go. And one more. So you can see these two holes here, they're gonna line up to this. You gotta make sure it's going the right way. There you go. Okay, and now your end piece again with the lock washer and bolt, it's gonna go right there. You're gonna screw that like this. Yeah, make sure that's nice and tight. So now I just brought this down. I brought it down here so I can get closer to the ground. If I wanted to go up higher, I would have brought these up this way and brought those spacers down and put them underneath there. So that's all you gotta do to adjust that stringer line. It's not that hard, it's not that complicated. So once again, bring those down or up. Either way, you're good to go. And once again, the Kohler motors are great. This is the XT Series 6.7 549 cc. So it's a strong motor. It's a very good motor. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to start this up, and I'm hoping that it starts up as easily as it did the last 100 times that I tried to start it. One pull. I've never had to pull more than once on this trimmer to get it started. So I hope it works here, because I'm going to look like a fool. But I'm going to try starting it up right now. All right, so let's bring this on over here. I'm going to turn it this way. Pulling my handle, I'm gonna bring this down to fast. One pull. Here we go. Oh, I thought I was gonna look like a fool. One start every single time. I love it. So now you can see that this blade is turning. This line is turning. And I'm gonna let go of this handle here. And it's gonna stop. So now I can put this down, I can walk away, I can do what I need to do. I can go pick something up. I come back over and pull it again. There it goes, starts to turn. Now here's the slow. Remember, I'm bringing this up towards the turtle. I push down, it goes fast again, all right? Now if I wanna shut this off, I'm just gonna bring that down, I'm gonna pull this up, and it shuts down all by itself. What's really amazing about this, there's no primer bulb on this thing. It just starts. It's a good motor. These are good tools. Everything that I've tried from Dirty Hand Tools, unbelievable. They're excellent and built really heavy duty. And just so you know, the tires here, they're hard plastic and they're bigger, so you're able to go through some heavy terrain, and they really work out nice. And trust me, this over here where I'm about to take you, that is heavy terrain. It definitely beats it up a little bit. So we're gonna head over that way, and I am going to show you how to cut. Now remember, when we get over there, we're not gonna go straight in. We're gonna keep our discharge chute open. We're gonna hit those high weeds. Those are really thick high weeds. We're gonna hit those. I'm gonna tilt that handle down, and it says it in the manual. You know, tilt the handle down a little bit and bring that front end up a little bit, because if you're hitting the ground with that ball, it's going to slow it down, number one. But number two, you're not going to go in there and just start cutting down trees with this thing, right? So you're going to go in, you're going to hold that handle down, says in the manual, cut the higher pieces down a little bit, come back, and then hit it again with the front end down a little bit lower, and that'll give it a nice even cut. And then once you get the heavy stuff down, you're going to be able to go back, and you won't have to worry about struggling so much. It's just like an edger, right? You know, you go alongside your driveway the first time, you think you're gonna dig those blades all the way down, it's not gonna work, it's gonna stall out on you. You have to make sure that you make a cut first, and then another cut, maybe sometimes even a third cut, but it will work on you. So I'm gonna take you over there to the heavy stuff, and we're gonna see how it works. All right, let's check it out here. I think you get the point. And once again, you can come down a little bit lower now and hit it. Gives it that nice slow cut. Alright. So, oh no, you can see this is pretty heavy stuff. And you can see it cut it down. Pretty nice. Now mind you, this stuff is wet, but you can see I got very low there, a couple other areas. All that was cut down by this. You can see where it's turning brown just because I cut so much off. and it just kept on going. So, you know, all in all, I am pretty happy with this. So let's wrap this portion up here and we will do the final review. Oh, and FYI, just to let you know, I cut down a lot of this field area with this. And it didn't take that long. So a lot of it was cut down by this machine. All right, so all in all, it's a very heavy duty, well-built machine. The motor on it is pretty good. It's a Kohler. You can't go wrong with Kohler. Now, I think I addressed maybe some of the issues that some people were having. I will say this, with the very heavy stuff, it does, you know, it does tend to wrap around a little bit, but you're gonna get that with any string trimmer, okay, and it's gonna slow it down a little bit. All you gotta do on this though is tilt it up and it'll spit it out and you just start again. And to be fair, I'm not using the correct line for that. I actually went to 155, like we talked about. I should be using 175, but I wanted to put it to the test. And as you can see, it cut down a lot of that area over there. So I'm fairly happy with this. I'm actually very happy with this. So if I were to review this, if I were to give this a rating of 1 to 5, 1 being the worst, 5 being the best, I'm gonna give it a solid 4. And the reason I gave it the 4 is because I do notice some slowdown, a little bit of slowdown when it comes to the very heavy stuff. But to be fair, 175 would have been a lot better. That being said, I don't know how much better. But I am very happy with this tool. I am very happy with the dirty hand tool, the trimmer mower, and you just can't go wrong with this. So check them out. I'm gonna put this on the blog, www.toolreviewzone.com. If this has helped you, please thumbs up, subscribe. I appreciate you watching. I hope this helped. Take it easy.